You are now entering the Queen Up Chronicles Talk Zone, the place where crowns are corrected, kings are supported, and the love is real.
Hold up, Jay.
Queen Up!
We're moving, we're grooving, we're building.
Great day, beautiful people. I am Jay West. This is Queen Up Chronicles Talk. Thank you so much for tuning in. I have an amazing show for you today, so please stay tuned in for the entire show. Have you ever thought about creating an event space in your home? Wow, it's a great idea. And it's something that you can do right in the comfort of your home if you have the space and you have the creativity. That's all you need. So my guests coming up, they're going to show you and tell you how to do just that. So stay tuned. We'll be right back after this commercial break.
We're grooving, we're building, we're loving, we're queening.
Yeah, queen up.
Queens, straighten your crowns.
Welcome back to Queen Up Chronicles Talk, and I am Jay West. I'm here with the CEO and co-owner of Tiki Sunset Retreat, Miss Brigette. Hey, Brigette.
Hey, how are you?
Girl, I'm doing amazing, honey. And I must let the viewers know that this is a power couple move that you've done with the Tiki Sunset Retreat, honey. Your husband, Robert, wasn't available because he's booked and busy, you know, and it's all to the good. Hey, Robert. Okay, but this is a dynamic duo, all right? So, Brigette, tell my viewers, this is a very unique name. How did you come up with Tiki Sunset Retreat?
Okay, well, I just put the three things together that are in the space that I have, which is the Tiki, as you guys can see in the background. Mm-hmm. And then right behind me, mm-hmm. we have some amazing sunsets sometimes that goes down back here.
Nice.
And is because this is a space where people can get together, retreat, have fun.
Yeah.
So that's how I came up with it. Tiki.
Okay. Hey, it makes sense. All things work together for your good.
Yeah.
Okay. Tiki Sunset Retreat. But I love it, honey. It's nice and sexy. Okay. And it says what it says. Okay. So listen, what motivated you to create this kind of business? Because this business is actually in your home, this event space.
Yes. Yes. And as your viewers may know, the event space alone, venues, are a big business. Okay. So we had like a renovation back here where we put the tiki and things like that. Mm-hmm. And as we were sitting back here, we were like, hey, this is kind of a nice spot that people want to come and hang out or whatever. And before, as you know, when we were doing the show before, we used the house that I was in as a space to do the show. So it's kind of like after COVID, COVID did a hurting on everybody, you know.
Yeah, COVID was very devastating. Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, but out of bad always comes good. And out of that, restaurants started to close down, venues were closing down, people weren't allowed to socialize.
Right.
And that was the year that I retired after working 30 years at the police department, as you know.
Congratulations on your retirement, honey. That deserves a round of applause, okay? 30 years on any job, okay? Congratulations. Yes.
Thank you. So after that, I wanted to travel. But as you have it was in 2020, COVID hit the world, and nobody was anywhere.
Nobody ready.
So out of that, restaurants close. What is the first thing you do to celebrate? Or most people do. They go to restaurants or they rent out a venue and they have a party, right?
Right.
All of that was shut down. So out of that was born this niche where people were using their homes as the venue space to celebrate and do events and parties and things like that.
Right.
I started investigating it more and I found apps that you can actually list your home on.
Wow.
And the clients will come to you. You send out a description and the client, and that's basically how we got started. I just found some apps and listed it, and we started going from there.
And that is amazing, because like you said, when COVID hit, everything was shut down. But when the world started to gradually open back up, the ideal situation, this niche, as you said, it opened up and it allowed you to have it a private event space so that you're still not around a multitude of people. The crowd, the numbers are lower, as opposed to going up to a regular event space. So it made sense.
Yes. Absolutely.
So I congratulate you on that and stepping outside of the box and finding your lane. So what we're going to do, we're going to take a quick commercial break. And when we come back, we're going to find out exactly what is Tiki Sunset Retreat and what kind of packages or services do you offer. So stay tuned. This is Queen Up Chronicles Talk. I am Jay West. Don't go nowhere.
Tiki Sunset Retreat hosts a variety of events. This beautiful engagement party is where the bride said yes. At this time, Tiki Sunset Retreat is focusing on government agencies, corporate parties, law enforcement, and other nonprofits. So make sure to check them out on their website and also on Instagram at Tiki Sunset Retreat.
Welcome back to Queen Up Chronicles Talk. I am Jay West, and I'm still here with the co-owner of Tiki Sunset Retreat, Miss Brigette. Brigette, listen, girl, this is a great conversation. I'm having so much fun. Again, thank you for being here with me. So what services do you offer in your packaging, Brigette?
Okay, so this is what makes us different, because we are basically an outdoor venue. You know, okay. We have Tiki here. We're on the water. Mm-hmm. So we do a lot of weddings. Like, let's say we do weddings. And the most unique thing that we offer with our weddings is a boat where you can come down the aisle.
Oh, wow.
You know, you can come down the aisle and you can use that for
a boat. Wait a minute, did you say a boat?
A boat, yes.
A yacht? Baby, I'm here for it. Okay, carry on.
Not yet. But no, we have a boat, so we use that in our services. Have okay. a surprise party, let's say.
Nice.
And you know, we pick you up from a different location, the party will be here waiting for you, and you come down and surprise, you know, wow. you have it's just a different thing that we offer, that we do. You know, we have a variety of different services. We even offer date nights on the beach, you know, but we'll get into
nice. I absolutely love it, honey. I'm ready to book already. I'm gonna tell you, honey. Let me see who I can get to book me at the Tiki Sunset Retreat, baby. Okay. Listen, I love it. I love it. Thank you for this great information, because people are actually learning how to create an event space from the comfort of their home and the privacy of their home. And it's a private event. I absolutely love it. So what kind of businesses or any celebrities or entertainers have rented out your space?
Oh gosh. Okay. We had TLC come here and do two episodes of I Am Jazz.
Okay. I don't know. TLC is the TV network?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Nice. Okay.
Yes. They came here and they did two episodes of I Am Jazz.
Okay.
I've worked with, I don't know if you've heard of her, Rachel Fitch. She's a really big social media person. She has like a couple of million followers.
Okay.
She
came here nice.
And you use back here just to take a photo and a 5-second video.
Oh, wow.
You know, we also work with DeVille. He's a big, big reggae artist. He found us through the apps.
Okay.
He came here and did a video for his latest hit. It's called Happy. Mm-hmm. And if you go to YouTube and look up the video Happy, you're going to see the scene where his wife or his girlfriend is at. It is here. It was recorded.
Nice, honey. I love it. Okay, so we're gonna share that video with the viewers, because honey, it looks like it's hot and popping. I viewed it before we started the interview, and baby, he is hot. Okay, no disrespect to this woman, but baby, he is nice. Okay, so listen, we're gonna take a quick commercial break, enjoy this video of the reggae artist, and come back. We'll be right here with some more information on how to create an event space, a private event space, in the comfort of your home. All right, yeah. I am Jay West.
Hope you know what you mean to me. When you're with me, I feel complete. I'd give up everything before I let you go. As long as
welcome back to Queen Up Chronicles Talk. Thank you so much for staying tuned in. I am having so much fun with Brigette. And I hope that you all enjoyed that video on the commercial break, honey, because I was doing a little 1-2 step over here. I tell you, that's all I got. I only got 2 steps for you, okay? So I hope you enjoyed the video. So Brigette, tell the viewers, what are your 2 most popular packages that the customers are purchase?
Our 2 most popular is, number 1, our date nights. Mm-hmm. Our date nights are absolutely fabulous. You can come and literally have a romantic date night for 2, for 4, for 6. We can give you a live singer. We can give you a live dancer. Mm-hmm. We provide the food, the entertainment, the decoration. You come here for a birthday dinner, an anniversary dinner.
Wow.
That's our most popular package because they, you know, it's different. You just step out of the box. People think you're just going to somebody's house. Yeah. And then when they back, it's tailored to their vision, their design, you know, and love. It's different.
Oh my goodness. I love it. So your packages are all inclusive. So you got the food, the decoration, the entertainment. Is this all included through your services?
Yes. Yes, it is all included. They pick out the menu that they want to eat, whether it's steak, chicken, we give them, and it normally comes from their favorite restaurant or the restaurant that we normally use.
Okay.
So everything is included. The table service, you get your own private waitress back here, catering to only you.
You know, it's not like a restaurant. I love it.
Yeah, it's different.
So what is the time frame? Is there a time limit? Is it a 2-hour event or 2-4 hours? Or what does that entail?
Date nights are normally 2 hours and they normally occur in the evening, of course, dinner. But sunset time. So
yeah, because you want to get that great sunset in the back now. You want to get that, you know, that aesthetic. Okay. A date night is not a date night on the water without the sunset. Okay.
Yes.
Nice.
Yes.
So date night is 2 hours.
Mm-hmm. Yes, where you always get the best seating in the house. You know what I mean? Music, everything tailored to you. So date nights are normally 2 hours, but the events, which is our second popular package, you know, the birthday parties and the weddings. Nice. The wedding, you get tables, chairs, you get linen, you get prompts, decorations. We have, you know, certain packages that come with all of that. And then if you want to add, you know, entertainment, or you want to add music, you want to add, you know, just different things to experience different, we provide all of that for you.
Oh, wow. That is absolutely beautiful. Well, honey, I was perusing your page and I saw an absolutely amazing, a beautiful wedding. And I was like, wow, because it doesn't look like you can do all of that in that space, right? Because I must admit, I must tell my viewers, I've been to the space. It's a beautiful space, okay? And like you said, Brigette, you can make it your own. You can create whatever you want to create in that space. And the option of being on the water, honey, who doesn't love being near the water, right? It just brings about a calm, right? A peace, right? So I appreciate these services, girl. So listen, I know, because you gifted me with it, I know that you have an additional service on top of the amazing Tiki Sunset Retreat, right? So let's talk about, honey, the Airbnb where I spent the weekend. Let's talk about that. Because thank you so much. I thank Robert for that. I really, really needed that quick getaway, that staycation. Girl, okay?
Happy you enjoyed. Yes, yes, yes. So we have an Airbnb. It's literally on Fort Lauderdale Beach.
Wow.
On the beach. Like you walk out of home, down past the restaurant and onto the sand. Okay.
Yes.
In that space, we incorporate that Airbnb into our date night or events here. Let's say you want to have an event and you have people coming in from out of town. Mm-hmm. Boom. We got you a spot over here at the hotel.
Right.
I mean, if you have a date night and you don't want the date night to end, boom, you book the room and you're all set for the night. You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You just basically we're trying to step right now. We are listed on Airbnb and VRBO, but we are trying to step out of that and do our thing and only use that room for our events.
Girl, it was beautiful. So again, I thank you so much. So we got to show the viewers a quick video of the Airbnb that you offer with your services. All right. So we're going to take a quick commercial break. We got some great information to share. Don't go anywhere. So check out this video, honey, of this Airbnb where yours truly stayed. Yes, I did. And I loved it. Stay tuned.
Welcome to your oasis. Tiki Sunset Retreat offers an amazing Airbnb located right on the Fort Lauderdale, Florida waterway. Look at the lobby of the hotel. You take the elevator and you meet me at the seaside. That's what it is. The room has two beds and a balcony. Look at that view. And then the amazing access to the Fort Lauderdale waterway. It's absolutely breathtaking.
Welcome back to Queen of Chronicles Talk. I am Jay West. Now, I hope you enjoyed that video that you just saw. Now, rush to your computer and rent that Airbnb, okay? I don't want you to walk. I want you to run to your computer, right, and rent it. Because it's an amazing space, right? So, but I would be remiss if I didn't acknowledge Brigette. You probably recognize her from us previously connecting on our first podcast, which was just simply titled Queen Up Chronicles, right? She was my co-host. It was an amazing time. We did a full season together, you know, and yeah. She retired and went on to do some other endeavors like the Tiki Sunset Retreat. And I'm here doing my solo thing and I absolutely love it. So Brigette, thank you so much. And I appreciate you assisting me and working with me on that episode, on that podcast, actually.
Jay, let me tell you, I had an amazing time. The way we worked together, we laughed, we did different events together. Remember that event we did, the modeling show?
Right.
I mean, it was just a great time. I enjoyed that time.
It really was. It really was. Let's tell the viewers how they can reach you, contact you, and book these services.
Okay, well, they can go to our website, which is simply tikisunsetretreat.com. Mm-hmm. Our Instagram, @tikisunsetretreat. Our email, if you want to reach us, tikisunsetretreat@gmail.com. So if you remember Tiki Sunset Retreat, you're going to find us somewhere.
Right. Tiki Sunset Retreat, keywords.
Yes.
Okay. Then you got them. You're connected. So I appreciate your time, honey. I know you have to go, but I appreciate you. I love you. And I want people to come out and you know, participate, support. Not only celebrate, but support Black-owned businesses, minority-owned businesses. We are stronger together, right?
Yes. And before I go, I just want to tell your viewers about some of the up-and-coming packages that we got. We're going to be doing memorial services, candlelight vigil.
Oh, wow. People. Okay.
We're doing fishing for young boys and men. We're going to be working with nonprofit organizations. We're going to be doing fundraisers, mini cruises. Okay. You know, want to go date night to a restaurant on the Intercoastal. We got you. You know what I mean? So we have a wide variety of things coming.
Oh, wow. Well, you was holding back a little bit, sis.
You know.
Holding back on me. Okay. All right, nice. So you heard it here. This is the CEO, co-owner of the Tiki Sunset Retreat. Thank you again, Brigette, for being here. I appreciate the time and have an amazing day.
You too. Love you.
So, I love you. I love you more. So stay tuned. We have more great show coming up for you. I am Jay West, and this is Queen Up Chronicles Talk 1. Queen Up Chronicles Talk. I am Jay West, and I'm here with the CEO and owner of JMYB Clothing Apparel. What's up, Josh?
What's up?
Thank you so much for being here. So listen, tell the viewers, what does JMY mean?
JMYB means just mind your business.
Just mind your business. Okay. Just how did you come up with that name? Because that's very unique. By the way, I love it. But how did you come up with that name? So you're kind of like giving advice at the same time, giving some fly clothes, right?
I'm basically giving a voice without speaking.
Right. Yeah. I absolutely love that.
Yeah, and I came, one day, maybe I came out with it maybe late 2016.
Okay.
And I was just, you know, chilling with a bunch of friends and we was just hanging.
Yeah.
And, you know, the idea, we were talking about ideas and just Mind Your Business just came to my head. And, you know, I'm like, I always live that type of life where I just mind my business. I stay out of people's business. And I did my homework. Mm-hmm. I looked up Just Mind Your Business to make sure nobody had the name already.
Right.
And it just came like that.
Right. So I'm going to tell you, Josh, if everybody just minded their business, it would be a better world. Don't you agree?
Oh, yeah. The world would be a totally better place, man.
I'm telling you, because people are always in somebody else's business. So let me ask you, were you always like into fashion or a nice dresser? Where's this passion coming from?
Well, I always had my own style. I always had my own unique style. I never wanted to be like nobody else. Like, I always, you know, dressed in my own way. You feel me? I was never like the mannequin type person. You feel me? I always had my own style. I rock me a white tee and some jeans and some kicks and still feel like I'm the flyest guy in the room. You feel me? So it was always in me. You know, my dad, he was into fashion. My mom was into fashion. My little brothers was into fashion. And, you know, my homies. So I was like, hey, let me try this out real quick.
Right. Now, that is absolutely wonderful. So you come from a fashionable family. That's great. Okay, so when you think about the ideas that you want to, like your line, like the different products, like T-shirts, hats, your pants, how do you come up with these ideas?
I just look at other brands, you know, like the big brands. I look at my friends' brands and I just like, you know, every brand should have at least a shirt, hat, a hoodie, maybe some shorts, you know, just as much as apparel that you can have dropping, like, you know what I'm saying? The more the better.
Okay.
Sweatsuits, hoodies, you know, all that good stuff.
Right. So you offer pretty much everything. Is it more like athletic wear, Josh?
I would call it urban wear. Maybe
okay.
The comfortable wear, like, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Yeah.
When I looked at your page, and I absolutely love your T-shirts, I love the sweats. I mean, I'm going to just be honest. I love everything, right?
The hats.
It's just really stylish. And like you said, it shows a level of comfort while staying fashionable and relevant, right? When you go out.
Yeah, because people always, they see it, then they like, dang, I don't know if I should say something to him. He look like he ain't, he want us to mind our business for real. So.
Right. So the name kind of working for you and against you, Josh, right? Because they're looking at you and saying, listen, he's saying, just mind your business, you know, university.
Yeah.
But at the same time, you want them to mind your business and support you in that, right?
Yeah, facts. Because I know a lot of people feel the same way I feel, but they just, you know, they might not speak on it. You feel me? I'm giving it to you that you can wear this stuff and, you know, it just represents how you feel. Like,
exactly.
I feel like anybody wearing any designer, anything you wear, you want it to represent you at the end of the day. You feel me? So